First order of business today. I am very sorry I missed you all last Friday. I lost power for over a week. Apparently we live in the year 1924, and it took a long time for my area to recover from that tropical storm. Secondly, if you did in fact miss looking at this ugly mug for the whole week, don't fret, you'll never have to miss me again. These little guys are going up for pre-sale next Friday. Do I think anybody's gonna want a little mini-me on their bed or shelf? No, but I figured it couldn't hurt to try. I mean, look how cute he is. This is the most adorable thing I've ever seen. I'll remind you guys again next week when they go up for pre-sale, if you do, in fact, want one of these. And finally, onto today's video. I wanted to do something pretty big, probably the biggest verses I've ever done before. And because everyone and their mother has their own unique variation for this recipe, I figured a good old fettuccine alfredo showdown would be perfect. Entering the ring today is going to be Steven from Not Another Cooking Show, our good pals over at Tasty, Sam the Cooking Guy, and then Chef John from Food Wishes. If you're new to the show, welcome, but today I'm going to test every single one of these recipes as accurately as I possibly can, weigh the pros and cons, and then rank them 1 through 4 at the end of the video. And today, I might just have an idea to where I can Frankenstein these all, take the best parts of each one, and then make my own variation. I'm getting a little bit ahead of myself though, so let's get right into this one. So technically, we have 5 recipes to make today, the most out of any verses I've ever done before, and each one needs some amount of good Parmigiano-Reggiano cheese. And to make sure I'm gonna have enough, I headed straight back to the cheese section in which I got the Parmesan wheel for the flaming cheesy pasta, and picking up a quarter wheel of the highest quality Parmesan cheese I can find, aka another $200 block of cheese. This store is single-handedly making me bankrupt, and also, don't be upset if I have another sponsor next week. Anyways, to make Not Another Cooking Show's recipe, I grabbed my Parmesan block and some good quality butter, kosher salt, and some fettuccine. If you couldn't tell already, I'm doing this one first because it is by far the simplest, quickest recipe to do. You literally only need to grate about a cup of your cheese, cook your pasta in some water that's just below boiling, and then in a separate pan, toss everything together. Your butter and pasta, the pasta water, and some cheese. I will be honest and say that I've never loved this method for either Alfredo sauce or even carbonara. I just feel like it's pretty hard to get that nice, thick, glossy sauce at the end, especially when you just dump in all your cheese like Steven did. No matter how much pasta water I add, I almost always get some of these globs of cheese on the side that pretty much get wasted. For the most part, the rest of this came together, so I plated up a nice portion, and recipe number one is ready to be tasted. I guess it's pretty cool you can make an entire meal with just 3 ingredients. Technically 5 if you count the water and the salts. But it smells really good. It looks a little dry. This just screams super classy Italian restaurant. That has good food, might be overpriced. The pasta is cooked perfectly. The salt level is really good as well, and it only really relies on the Parmesan and the pasta water for the salinity, so. It's very good, but it's very basic. I feel like it's a pretty good place to start too, so let's see what some other ones have in store for us. Next to enter the ring today is our good buddy, Sam the Cooking Guy, with his version of restaurant-style chicken fettuccine alfredo. I needed some more cheese and panko breadcrumbs, salt and pepper and crushed red pepper flakes, garlic and vermouth, heavy whipping cream, fettuccine pasta, butter, some flour, a few eggs, chicken breasts, and fresh parsley. Did I forget to mention at the beginning that we're not just making pastas today? The remaining 4 recipes are all gonna have completely different kinds of chicken to go right on top of our Alfredo mountains, starting with Sam's chicken cutlet. This actually perfectly exemplifies how different the same recipe can be depending on the person. Sam is gonna fry his, Tasty is going to pan sear theirs, Chef John poaches his chicken, and then I'm going to grill mine. Sam kind of has a cheat code on, though, because usually anything fried is delicious. Especially when you use very heavily seasoned panko breadcrumbs, you pound it out to a nice even thickness, and then get a beautiful golden brown crust around the outside. Now that that's ready to go, I started to work on my sauce, which is pretty straightforward as well. It starts with some oil and garlic. 95% of this is made up of the heavy whipping cream, which will reduce quite a bit. And then it's seasoned with some salt and pepper, the red pepper flakes, some vermouth, and then at the very end, some parsley and the cheese. Once it started simmering, I let it evaporate off at a very low temperature. There's really no reason to rush this. If you have a large-bottomed nonstick pan, it's not gonna take that long anyways. And a few minutes before it reached my desired consistency, I dropped my pasta, let it cook to a nice al dente, toss that in, and then, like I said, finish it off with some fresh parsley. Did I realize after the fact that there is no butter in this and I shouldn't have told you to get some? Yes, but it looks pretty good. It smells even better, so I finished it off with some more parsley and cheese on top, and it is time to give recipe number two a shot. Okay, well, before I got chicken juices and parsley all over my table, I was trying to show you how pretty this looked until I walked down here and showed my mom, and she said it looked like Applebee's. Oh my god. Sam might not be the most traditional or authentic chef out there when he's remaking dishes like this, but this man does not know what bland is. Everything he makes is just like... The first hit you get is definitely the creamy richness from the cream and the cheese. But then you get like the garlic after that. It finishes with the chili heat. Calorically, it might not be the best for you, especially knowing the recipes to come. But as far as taste, the difficulty, appearance, all that stuff, this is definitely gonna hold the number one spot for now. We cannot forget the third contestant today, the David Seymour Channel classic, Tasty, and their easy chicken Alfredo penne. You're gonna need some penne pasta and a hunk of Parmesan, salt and pepper and dried basil, whole milk, dried oregano, some butter and garlic, flour, more chicken breasts, and fresh parsley. I wanted to get all the prep work out of the way first, the cheese, garlic, parsley, and chicken. And I've seen a lot of confused comments about when I break out this cheap plastic cutting board. This is literally just for like chicken and pork when I'm cutting raw meats, so I don't have to wash this enormous wooden cutting board, just this smaller plastic one. We all know I'm not the brightest YouTube chef out there, but it's only taken me 5 years to pick up some little hacks like this. Now this one comes together in three different parts. You're gonna boil your pasta separately, you're going to make your sauce separately, but you're gonna start by cooking your chicken separately too. If I'm not mistaken, this recipe I'm following was 4 years old now, and stuff like this really takes me back, because you can tell they tried to simplify recipes, allow you to get a decent product with little to no cooking skills. So I always admired Tasty for that. A perfect example of that is the fact that in this video, every single spice and seasoning they use is a half teaspoon. So essentially, one part of the same measuring utensil. It just kind of limits the places where you could have potentially messed up. So again, I do admire them for stuff like this. And literally, all you have to do once your chicken is cooked, your sauce is finished, and your pasta is ready, is throw it all in a bowl with some more parsley and some more cheese and mix it together. I believe we are quite a few hours in to filming this video already, but right now it is time to try recipe number three. If you're wondering, yes, I did use a dirty bowl for this that I just had the chicken in. What about it? Not the raw chicken, the like cooked chicken I had set aside. Anyway. Ooh. I definitely don't love it. I think the roux is kind of causing any excess sauce to get a film over it, even though I cooked it minutes ago. And it's really herb heavy. There's like a ton of oregano in this, and that always just throws me off. Like, why would you put an oregano in cream sauce, especially in Alfredo sauce? I feel like that flavor is just so reminiscent of a red marinara pizza sauce. It just doesn't work as well. The chicken is the best part of this. It's cooked pretty well. I think if you used those dried herbs just on the chicken and then tossed it after, it would have been fine. You didn't have to dump all that dried stuff in your cream sauce as well. I think that's a bit overkill. I'm just not vibing too much with this one. For now, I think it'll sit in third place. Making his second appearance on the channel is Chef John from Food Wishes with his chicken fettuccine Alfredo. You need some heavy cream and chicken stock, your salt and pepper again, and some more cheese, surprise. A box of fettuccine and parsley, some garlic and a few eggs, and some chicken. Out of all of the recipes we're doing today, I'm pretty confident in saying that this one is the most different. Interestingly enough, we are parboiling chicken in some chicken stock. This should hold up flavor-wise. I don't know about appearance, to be honest with you. But we also have to make a chicken stock and cream base that we're going to eventually dump over the pasta. That base has a tempered egg yolk in it. This is a little bit out there in general. According to the video, the most important technical part of this is cooking your pasta a few minutes shy of being al dente, because like I said, this finishes with the hot cream that'll finish cooking the pasta itself and also hopefully inject a ton more flavor into the noodles. I sliced up the chicken breast. I shredded probably my 7th cup of Parmesan cheese today. Added that in with the pasta, plated it all up. Are you guys at home tired of the copious amounts of cheese and cream that has been going on today? Because I think my internal organs are just about there. Almost to the end here, peeps. We are slowly chugging along. This is recipe number 4 of the day, and it smells so unbelievably good. I think I've said that about all of them, because they all do. You guys might have to give me a minute here. Wow. I didn't get any chicken in that bite, actually. From a flavor and practicality standpoint, I can understand why he poached the chicken. You know, you're infusing flavor with that chicken stock. You're gonna toss it in sauce and herbs anyway, so the appearance doesn't matter all that much. But parboiled chicken in general, even when you shred it and toss it in the sauce, I feel like it has a very distinct mouthfeel. It's almost got like a little slight rubberiness, even when it's cooked to perfection. I made sure I had a thermometer in this. This sauce, on the other hand, though, is one of the best Alfredo sauces I've had. I wish I had a pint glass of it, because I would drink the whole thing. It's just so unbelievably, like, savory and rich and full feeling, if that makes sense. Obviously, that all comes from the egg yolk, the chicken stock. It's just next level. And I love the method of cooking that sauce separately, dumping it on your almost finished cooking pasta, and then letting the pasta absorb it too. That's like infusing even more flavor into your pasta. If we were having a chicken competition, obviously Sam would win. That chicken was the best of the day. But if you put that on this, I probably would have been on the floor, because this dish in total was just fantastic. Before I sign off today, a lot of people on the Last Versus episode recommended that I either incorporate my own recipes into these videos or do a conglomerate of all the best parts of the recipes I make. And I think I'm gonna merge those two ideas. I'm gonna take my completely homegrown, completely self-constructed recipe for fettuccine Alfredo and then kind of sprinkle in all the best parts from the recipes that we've made today. Now, besides marrying all the best qualities of those recipes together, the goal of this last variation is also to cut the richness. Because as much as I loved some of these other recipes, it's kind of hard for me to finish one, as it's so rich, it's so heavy. But I got a couple ideas to combat that. I grabbed some chicken stock and kosher salt, black pepper, more cheese, and pappardelle pasta. Dried thyme and crushed red pepper flakes, cayenne pepper and oregano, vegetable oil, vermouth, heavy cream, parsley, some smoked paprika, more butter, fresh garlic and shallots, and our last piece of chicken breast. I believe I mentioned earlier that the way I was gonna cook my chicken was out on the grill for a number of reasons. I definitely feel most comfortable cooking it out on the grill and knowing that I'll get a good end product. It's a lot healthier than, say, a deep fried method, but also I feel like a nice grilled chicken is just synonymous with cream sauce pastas, and to take it up another notch, I'm gonna whip up a quick Cajun seasoning comprised of one part thyme, oregano, black pepper, and cayenne, and then two parts of the crushed red pepper flakes, salt, and paprika. I've noticed, as I've grown in the kitchen, there is a method to most of the madness when I'm cooking for myself or my family. I like a spice blend like this to contrast the richness of a cream sauce. I like to generously pat that on first and then dip it in some vegetable oil to prevent sticking. And side note, if it looks like I'm grilling in the dark in this next shot, it's because I am. It's about 2:30 in the morning. If you were on my Instagram, you'd know that already. But this is the last recipe of the night. It's been a long day of filming, so hopefully my neighbors enjoy waking up to the smell of Cajun chicken at 3 in the morning. Next up, I'm gonna drop my pasta and start softening my shallots and garlic pretty much at the same time. The pasta is gonna cook in maybe 3 minutes because it's such a thin, fresh noodle. And I'm also gonna need a ton of this pasta water to dump right on top of my vegetables and then let that reduce before starting the butter emulsification. I figured I would pull out all the stops here to guarantee us a thick and creamy end product. Between the heavy cream and Parmesan cheese, as well as this emulsified butter, there's no way we're not gonna get a nicely thickened sauce. For the rest of this, I pretty much fused together Sam and Chef John's recipes with Chef John's chicken stock and the cheese being added at the very end over no heat. And then Sam's vermouth and completely thickening the sauce before adding in the pasta at all. All I know is that it is very late. I have not been hungry since the first recipe when we started this. But this one just looks too damn good to pass up. So let's give recipe number 5 on the day a try. Yes, it smells amazing. It looks really good. It's not authentic, but I'm sure it tastes good. Yada, yada, yada. Let's just get into this. I'm not gonna sit here and say that this is definitely the best one, but it definitely is not the worst one, that's for sure. This right here, ladies and gentlemen, is the perfect marriage. Yes, it is very rich and thick, but it's got so much heat coming from the chicken, the red chili flake, the cayenne pepper, it's just balanced so well. This pasta basically answers my call last time to drink the damn sauce, because it adheres to the outside of it so well. This is really good. You know what? Let's bring homie back for the final taste test. Where do I put him? You good there? You gonna stay? Nope. It's been a really long day. My insides are screaming. I'm sure I'm gonna be regretting this entire process tomorrow, but we've eaten some pretty damn good food, so I can't complain. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, leave me a big thumbs up. It is now 4 in the morning, if you didn't believe me. I'm exhausted, but I think this one was worth it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it as well. Don't forget that this little guy will be up for a pre-sale next Friday. Other than that, have a fantastic weekend, and I will see you right back here next time. Peace!
With the M, M without the A, D. Flipping burgers and my money super lazy. Try and make a meal tonight, they ain't pay me. Try and supersize my life with my A team. Yeah, our style wasn't wavy, but we had a vision. We could